Hello, and welcome to our show for the love of animals, the show about your favorite pets. You want to get your paper and pencils today because we have some great gifts from Santa's gift bag for your cat or your dog. I'm Darleen Pigford.
And I'm Greg Baur, and we want to tell our viewers about a couple of upcoming shows. We're going to repeat a show on first aid for dogs that Dr. Lenita Flannery did for some time ago.
Uh-huh.
And also we're going to have one on how do you handle the problem of grief when you lose a pet.
Oh.
And that's something we all have to face, and I think it'll be interesting. And Wicked here is in a festive mood today. And since it's festive, what do we mean by festive today, Darleen?
Well, we're going to take a look at products for your cat or dog in the area for play, which is very important, mm-hmm. then health and wellness, and then anything goes miscellaneous. So these are ideas that you might want to get your pet or your pet lover around the holiday season.
These would go for Wicked? These would go for pet lovers also, too.
Oh, absolutely, Greg. Anything to help the pet lover these days.
There we go. Okay.
Why don't you introduce our guests,
Greg? I'll be happy to. A couple of ladies that have been with us before and always do such a wonderful job. To Darlene's right here is Judy Hardy from Creatures Great and Small. And to Judy's right is Donna Groves, who is treasurer of Project Hope and a couple of our local animal organizations. So welcome. Thank you both for coming and spending time with us today.
We're so glad to have both of you back again.
And I'm really looking forward to all these little gifts and so on.
Judy, you work with Creatures Great and Small, mm-hmm. and I guess if I ask you about your fur family, it'd take the entire show, right?
Yes, definitely. Definitely. Yeah, I have plenty to talk about.
You have plenty to talk.
We probably won't go into all the detail today.
Okay. And Donna, in your fur family increase is now to what?
Oh, I have several kitties. One who's deaf
right.
from Project Hope, one who is blind from Project Hope, oh. one who's has one eye from Project Hope, and one who has three legs from Project Hope.
Oh my goodness! And yep. the three legs, is that tripod?
His name is Herbie.
Herbie. Okay.
He got hit by a car when he was just a kitten,
and
was brought into a local veterinary office and left there by someone who didn't own him, but a good Samaritan. They called and said, you know, can you help him? And so uh-huh. we took him.
Wonderful.
You have some real nice special needs cats mm-hmm. there at that point.
And you know all about special needs, don't you?
Yes, I also have one with one eye.
Well, you know, so do I.
Right. So
from Project Hope. And she was mad with me today when I brought her favorite toy. She couldn't find it.
Mm-hmm.
So Ginger Sue, my one-eyed cat, was very angry, but I promised her that I'd bring it back.
I felt like a real Scrooge. I packed up all their favorite toys and brought them to the TV show, and then they were
right.
like, where are you going?
Well, let's just get started. We wanted our viewers to see products that we know that our animals really like, and mm-hmm. they're fairly low cost, and we have good reasons for choosing them. And so you've got Santa's gift bag of toys that help us play with our animals.
What have you got there? This is my deaf cat's favorite toy.
Oh my goodness!
He loves to chase my one-eyed cat straight down this end, out that end. They also have these holes that they can run in and out, so they love this tunnel.
They have the
best time.
Now, do they just play it without your being there?
Without my being there, they will run up and down through there, chase each other. They will walk through the living room and will find a reason to go through the tunnel. I mean, and it's self-contained. I mean, they don't need your help to play, you know.
Uh-huh.
Those are the best kind.
Mm-hmm. And yep. they love this thing.
My goodness.
And this is one of those that when I packed it up, they were going, you better be bringing that back, Mom. You better not come back without it.
And what do you call this?
I call it a tunnel. I'm not sure.
Just a tunnel. Okay.
Yeah. They make a cheaper quality, but they're very hard on it because they do run through it. So I found uh-huh. that the higher quality ones do last longer.
Okay.
It's one of those toys that you really need to invest in. Better grade of a tunnel because they are going to give it a hard workout.
That is so interesting. Heavens.
And it does pack away to where it's, you know,
yes,
fairly little.
That's
so
enough.
When company comes, they don't see that you're quite as crazy as you are.
You don't make it obvious.
So the cat tunnel.
The cat tunnel.
Okay. Oh, my, that's good. All right, what's in your gift bag for our dogs?
Okay, I found The dogs I have are just very destructive when it comes to their toys. I
mean, okay.
You get them something and it's just completely destroyed. So this is a great toy. It's made out of very hard rubber.
Okay.
They can chew on it. They can't tear it up. And what's really cool about it, it has a liver snack, and you put it in the hole.
Oh, okay.
And it takes them a long time to try to get that out. You know, they are constantly licking and trying to get it out, which keeps them occupied for a while. So if you're leaving the house and you leave your animal in, this gives them something to do without destroying maybe some things in your house.
What a wonderful idea.
And you can find that in most any store that, you know, sells pet toys.
And what's it called? Does it have a...
It's just called a Kong. A K-O-N-G.
K-O-N-G, mm-hmm. Okay.
But
I'm learning all new things.
Yeah, but that's great for dogs. And they have different sizes. They make these in, for puppies. They make them for bigger dogs,
gotcha.
And they make them for older dogs.
And this would be for
this
what?
Is for probably a younger dog, a grown younger dog, because it's really heavy rubber. But the ones are softer for puppies and stuff. So
neat.
But anyway, I love that.
Yeah. Fantastic. Mm-hmm. All right, Donna, what's in your cat bag?
Couple of these tunnel toys.
This
is my three-legged kitty's favorite toy.
Uh-huh.
Once it starts to going, he just attacks it. He'll attack it from the center, attacks it from the side. He'll pick it up, throw it around. But it's another one that once he starts, he doesn't need me around.
He
just plays with it. This is another version of that same toy that has a mouse inside and it goes round and round and round.
Uh-huh.
But
uh-huh.
they just chase it round and round, and it gives them a lot of exercise and keeps their mental faculties that don't as they're playing with it. So this one also has a little scratch pad, which is always good for them to
neat.
Not use your carpet or your couch.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Okay. All right.
That can be a problem.
What do we have now for dogs?
Okay, now we have a version of the Frisbee. I really like this because it's made out of like a cloth, a real strong cloth.
Okay.
Lots of seams in it to keep it strong. It's got like a little ball in the middle. And it's very easy to throw because you have like the holes, you can grip it better.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
And also it's easier on the dog when he catches it. You know, you get these hard plastic ones
that
kind of, you know, I would think it would hurt. I've never caught one, but
not with her teeth anyway.
No, that's right. But anyway, we have one, our lab, that just, he's just crazy about Frisbee. But I found this is just a wonderful toy for him.
Okay.
That's a great version of it. That's really neat.
Yes, I like it.
All right. All right, what's underneath your Christmas tree over there?
Well, everybody knows that kitties like lasers, laser pointers.
Yeah.
They love to chase them. But sometimes mom is tired, and they will sit and want to do this forever. So I found this with Drs. Foster and Smith, which is a catalog company. You can also find them on the web.
Uh-huh.
And this is a version of a laser, and what it does is it just makes a laser pointer point on the wall,
and it dances.
And it dances by itself, and the kitties can play without you having to sit there and make the twirly motion on the wall. So it's kind of a laser pointer without you having to do any work.
Oh.
And you just shoot it towards a blank wall or something.
Mm-hmm. Right.
How neat.
Yeah.
Which of your cats likes that one?
Oh, all of them like it. It's still not quite the same as you doing it.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
They like you. Yeah.
They like your interaction, but they all will sit there and play with the wall. Riley, my one-eyed kitty, will like that one a lot. Yeah.
That is so neat. Well, I know what goes on our shopping list. Okay, what do we have, Judy?
Okay, this is the version of, you've seen a rag rug before.
Right.
A lot of times I use those with my animals to, you know, to make a bed out of because it's kind of cheap that you can use. Well, the dogs just shred it up. They love playing with the rag rugs. They just chew it apart. So this is kind of a version of what the rug is made out of, and it's intertwined so they can't really tear it up. It's good for tugging, especially since I have so many dogs. You know, there's more than one that play with.
Okay.
They try to get it from each other. So I found that this is, you know, it's durable and they love playing with it.
And it's washable.
It's washable, exactly.
And that's so important these
days. Yes, it sure is.
Oh.
But Wicked over here is going crazy looking at the toy, Judy.
We have his interest.
I'm saving the best for last, Wicked.
Okay. All right. What's what's last in our bags here?
Well.
The toys.
Mice. You don't have to spend a lot of money to make a kitty cat happy. Mm-hmm. Stevie Wonder, my little blind kitty,
uh-huh.
loves to play fetch. But being sight impaired,
it
has his disadvantages. So he needs a mouse that makes a noise so he can follow it. So this one, he can follow because he hears where it lands. So you throw it
and he can follow it and bring it back to you. But you throw the kitty, the mouse that doesn't have a sound inside, it'll go one way and Stevie will go the other. Yes. It's really quite sad. So you want to throw Stevie a mouse that has a rattle inside.
Oh, my
but
God.
They love the mice. You don't have to spend a lot of money to make them happy.
Oh,
wow. Neat idea. That's a new one on me.
Okay, Judy, what you just mentioned something. The best, you said the best.
Yes, well, I know we like squeakies, so.
Uh-oh.
And my dogs, really, this is a toy, but it's also an attention getter. Uh-huh. I mean, you can call them, and sometimes they just lay there and look at you, but uh-huh. You do this, man, they're up and after it. So, see, just like that. But anyway, they just love any kind of toy that has a squeaky in it.
Would last Wicket about two and a half weeks.
Well, it won't last that long at my house, but that's why it's kind of, you have to overlook, I mean, watch them as they play so you can not, so they won't tear it up, because it's very, they can tear it up real easily, especially my dogs because they're so big. But it is good for one at a time.
Oh, goodness.
Well,
Wicket.
Well, we're just getting started, but we're going to need to take a short break now.
Okay.
With a happy tale of a cat called SJ. So give a listen.
Hi, my name is SJ, and I'm a lively female cat, and I'm about a year old. I was found in a dumpster along with a couple of my brothers and sisters. I was brought to Creatures Great and Small, where my foster parents took me to the vet and got me fixed and up to date on my shots. I love dogs and other cats. My favorite thing to do is cuddle up with you at night. I am ready for a happy forever home, so please help me.
Welcome back. We hope you enjoyed that tale about SJ.
And isn't it wonderful that they rescued an animal? And it's terrible that it was in a dumpster.
Hunting for food along with brothers and
sisters.
Well,
I mean, no, probably somebody threw it away in the dumpster.
No, I don't know. But they were hunting for food
whatever.
We want to continue now with our show with Santa's Gift Bag. And, of course, this is the holiday season, and we know that things are tight with everybody, but our animals also need some help.
It's tight with the rescue people too, right?
Yes. Donna, why don't you tell us a little bit about what's going on with Project Hope?
Well, as always, we have a full house of cats and kittens and dogs and puppies. And we could use financial help, as always, and volunteers over at Project Hope. It's a no-kill rescue over in Metropolis.
Okay.
Do you have any idea approximately how many animals your house has?
About 100.
About 100.
Uh-huh.
And if our viewers will get their paper and pencil, we'll put on the screen how you can get a hold of Project Hope. And I think what Donna said, important, you know, as we say, money is tight.
Mm-hmm.
But volunteers have time.
Yeah. We can use your time. If you can't help monetarily,
yes,
we can certainly put you to work. We can always use donations of paper towels. We go through an inordinate amount of kitty litter.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
You know, hand sanitizer, things like that, bleach.
And just spending time with the animals over there.
And just spending time with the animal.
Play.
Play.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, I think...
Donna, if I wanted to make a donation...
Yeah.
What address? I would make it out to Project Hope Humane Society, and I would send it where in the mail?
To a P.O. Box 125, Metropolis, Illinois, 62960. We also have a website.
And your website is?
www.projecthopeanimalshelter.com. It's a long one.
Okay.
Or you can email us at info@projecthopeanimalshelter.com. Hope Animal Shelter.
And if I wanted to call and arrange to come over and volunteer, I could phone you at
618-524-8939.
All right.
Well, that's. I hope our viewers can give us some help there with Project
Hope. Me too.
So, Greg, why don't we take a short break and make sure that our viewers get this information and so they have time to write it down. All right?
Okay.
We'll take a short break and show you that information again from Project Hope No Kill Humane Society. Thank you.
Welcome back. And we're going to continue with Santa's gift bag. We're going to go to health items now.
Health and well-being.
And we could always use those sorts of things.
Oh, absolutely.
So, Judy, why don't we start with you with your gift bag on this one?
What have we got for dogs?
Okay. As you know, if you have dogs, you have fleas.
Oh!
No.
And even in the wintertime, we want to make sure that our dogs, especially if they're in a house, we want to protect them from that. Mm-hmm. So we always use a good name brand flea control.
Right.
Okay. And this one is especially good because it's also takes care of the ticks that cause Lyme disease. So that affects us humans as well. So that's one of the main things we don't want to forget when we have our dogs.
Yeah.
And I think a lot
sure
of people
flea and tick protection.
I think a lot of people think that you don't do flea stuff in the winter, but you do.
You do.
Oh, you do. Definitely, you do.
And what
it may not be as prevalent, but they're there.
Right.
You know?
And what you want to do is make sure that whatever brand you get, it kills the eggs.
Exactly.
All right.
Exactly.
Not the fleas, but the eggs.
Yeah.
Because they hatch. Well, we won't go into that. That's another show.
That's
another show.
That's
true. But that is so important.
Yes.
It's important for cats as well. So.
What you got there, Donna?
This is a natural brand of flea medicine for kitties. So you can do it the natural way.
All right.
Without
no
using chemicals.
Okay.
Also, you need to do that in the winter as well. And this is a flea comb, which is very good.
Okay, how do you?
You just brush through the hair, and you can tell if you have fleas or not, number one, to see if you have a problem. Sometimes you wonder, is it an allergy, is it a flea?
Right.
Yeah, and so this will help you to know that.
Yeah, particularly around their neck and their ears and probably right across their back.
Right.
Yeah. Those are excellent for their well-being. All right, let's keep going. What you got, Judy?
Then another product that we really don't want to forget is our heartworm preventative.
Yes.
Okay.
Because that is something that's very important. More puppies and dogs die of heartworms from heartworms than you may know. And if you wait too late, then the treatment is very expensive, and sometimes it doesn't work because you've waited so long.
Mm-hmm.
But this is a monthly medication, and it should be given. And most vets will tell you when to start it with your puppies. Usually it's after 7 months. Some have different ideas on that, but you need to talk to your vet, but you need to get the dog started on this, and they need to be tested for heartworms before you give them if they're not a puppy and going into adulthood. So that's a very important thing, and you don't want to miss a month with this.
Mm-hmm.
Great idea.
Okay.
Miss Don?
Well, a couple of my kitties live to be 21, so once they get to be older, you may need this. It's urine gone. When they have their little accidents, you need a good brand of urine remover. It's good on your carpets, on your couches, where they have their little accidents. And this stuff is good.
Okay.
And it
just
gets
a spray
out the
bottle. It gets out the smell, and it's like it never happened.
And getting out the smell is a critical thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
so that you don't repeat that same spot.
Right.
And if you use a natural one, don't use ammonia, because that's what's in urine.
That's what's in it to begin with. Did you hear that, Darleen?
Yeah, many years ago. Yes, I did. I was cleaning with ammonia. That was a no-no.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Judy?
Okay, and then this is similar to what she had for the cats, for the fleas. And it's but it also gets out, you know, unwanted hair and everything.
The undercoat.
Yeah, the undercoat for the dog.
Okay.
And it's sort of a bigger size for that. But you do the sides and the back. You got to be careful around the face.
Oh, you don't.
And
right.
You don't want to. You know, it will.
Because that's kind of
sharp. It's kind of tough on them. But anyway, that's very, very good.
Okay. And we need to do that even year round.
Yes.
Because that keeps that hair down. It keeps the fleas down.
Definitely.
And it's better to do it that way than to get it all over your house.
Exactly. Very much so.
Okay, Donna.
Well, the side sheaths on a kitty's claws, they need to come off. And they need, that's why they will scratch your couch if you don't give them something. So even if you don't have a kitty scratching post, just get them one of these little cardboard things, and they'll be able to use that to scratch on. You've got to give them something to be able to make that scratching motion so that they get those side sheaths off of their kitty fingernails.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, my foster kitty has just almost destroyed a scratching post, and I just wind the rope around it and say, go to it.
Have at it.
Judy?
Okay. And as dogs get older, they kind of act like we do. Their joints hurt and they don't get around as well as they usually do.
Uh-huh.
But so this is it has the chondroitin and the MSN.
Okay.
And it's a very good supplement to give them with with as growing old, because they really do need something to help them with joint problems.
Okay, so something for their joints.
Yeah, and you especially, you know, they don't complain. They can't tell you they're hurting.
They can't tell you, right.
So when a dog, you know, reaches like 6 or 7, he's probably, you see him having trouble getting up and stuff, that would be a good supplement to give him in his diet.
And these are a couple of good books, resources, Twisted Whiskers and Think Like a Cat, How to Raise a Well-Adjusted Cat. They're both by Pam Johnson Bennett, who's a feline behavioral consultant, and she lives in Nashville. She's very good at thinking like a cat, which is kind of hard for you to do to begin with, but she has some really good behavior tips and medical advice, so these are good books. One of them you can find in the public library.
Public library, yes.
Already?
Wow.
Oh. I think we've run out of items on that one, I think.
Well,
there's a lot. Do we have more?
Well, I don't know, but I didn't bring it this time, but my cats love their washable kitty beds.
Oh, yes.
I have a 12-pound cat or a 15-pound cat curled up in this little tiny basket, you know, and I have the ones that I can just toss in the washing machine, you know. So those are wonderful for their well-being.
Yes.
So.
Well, we'll let our viewers catch their breath for a minute while we listen to another happy tale, but keep that paper and pencil handy because we're going to hear some information about creatures great and small. So I think you'll enjoy this little tale about Fargo.
Hi, my name's Fargo, and I'm a loving male dog, and I'm about a year old. I'd been brought into the shelter as a stray and was going to be put down because I had no home. Then, creatures great and small came to the shelter and rescued me. I'm a hound mix, but I don't bark very much. In the summer, I love to lay on the front porch in front of the fan. For the winter, my mom brought me a heater, which I love very much. I play with dogs, and I like cats too. Sometimes my foster mom lets me come in and lay on the couch. Please help me find a happy forever home.
Welcome back. We hope you enjoyed that tale about Fargo. And one of our other local animal organizations that we would like to mention today, and it's up on the screen, is Four Rivers Bird and Animal Rescue. And if you're interested in getting a hold of Rhoda Bolton there, who's been a feature on our show also, she's at 4995 Meredith Road here in Paducah, and donations can be sent to her. You can contact them by telephone at 270-444-0385, and their email address over there is Comcast.net. little glitch there. But anyway, they also could use some help volunteer-wise and donation-wise. And speaking of that, Judy?
Our little happy tale was about a little animal from Creatures Great and Small.
And we know what great work they do, along as does with Project Hope. So Judy, tell us what's going on with Creatures Great and Small and how our viewers can help you.
Okay. Well, we have plenty of animals. We have, I guess we have right now for adoption, we have like 30-some dogs, which is a lot for us because we're a small group. We have probably 50-some cats as well. And cats are not moving so well right now. Our last adoption, it was very slow. Dog seems to be the thing right now. I don't know. I think it just has its little spurts. But we could use volunteers. We need fosters very much because we don't have a facility, so we count on our fosters to take care of these animals.
Fostering homes, right.
So it kind of piles up on people like me if we don't have the fosters. So and of course, we always need financial donations. You know, we can always use that for dog food, for vet bills, for, you know, many of the things that we need.
It sounds like the biggest place that they could help you is the foster part.
Yes, definitely, because that helps with, you know, then some of that is taken off of the others that we can, they take them to vets and they take them to the adoption.
Well, and if we get some viewers out there that would like to help out with fostering and just in general with you, how can they get a hold of you, Judy?
Well, they can call us at our hotline and leave a message, and our number is 495-0773, and they can leave a message and we'll be back with them and tell them what they can do to help us.
Okay.
And donations can be sent to?
You can send that to Post Office Box 9173, and that is Creatures Great and Small, of course. Mm-hmm. And it's Paducah, Kentucky 42002.
Yeah. And more information?
You can look
website.
Up. The website is www.helpthecreatures.com. And you can see, you can click on Pet Finders and you can find all our animals that we have for adoption. And then our email address is creatures, G and S. It's so long, we just did the G and S at hotmail.com.
Okay. Well, we hope that our viewers will see what they can do about helping out our three wonderful local animal organizations. They just do a lot for us and an awful lot for our animals. So. Well, Santa's gift bag is getting a little empty, but we still have some more things.
Oh, we still have some more.
Donna, what do we have in the miscellaneous area that doesn't fit anywhere?
Anything goes. Well,
anything
how about a shameless
goes.
Plug?
You got it.
One of the things we do to raise money in the holidays time at Project Hope is we do what we call gifts of purpose. Rather than giving something to someone at the holiday time that you don't know if they're going to like the size or whatever, we put together these bags, and inside you'll have a picture of a pet at Project Hope, and there'll be a note that tells you about that pet, and they go for $25, and we use that money, of course, to feed and shelter pets at Project Hope.
Bills.
This one is of my pet Snowball, and it would of course tell you that he's a deaf kitty, and that you know he was brought in from the street, and he you know didn't know that there was cars behind him because he couldn't hear
them.
Yeah, and it would tell you about a pet and what the money that they gave on your behalf is going to. So
what a neat idea.
And it's delivered for you.
Oh really?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Oh, now that's a winner.
That is nice.
Yeah, now that's a winner.
That
she just
great.
Gave me an idea.
Yeah.
Judy, what do you have there?
Okay, well, in our adoptions, we a lot of times we go to PetSmart and we have we're waiting there, and a lot of times they need certain wordless shampoo because in the winter time you can't really wash a dog that well. Yeah. So we have the wordless shampoo that we use on our dogs, and I found that's very beneficial because it makes them smell good and they look good. So that's a real
good
item that we
Wicked,
certainly
you
enjoy.
Hear that?
Uh-oh, Wicked.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, Wicked.
Well, I'll tell you what, we're running just a little short on time. Donna, what's the item in your bag that you most would not want to forget to talk about today?
How about our cookbook from Project Hope?
There you go.
Okay.
Well, you helped my Christmas shopping there.
Yes.
Positively Delicious. This is actually Positively Delicious, too. It's a collection of recipes from our shelter. They're $10 each, hardbound, and
great.
Call the shelter.
Yeah. All righty. And Judy?
Okay, I have one last one that I really like. This is a collar that it has a battery, and it illuminates light. And for those people that like to walk their dog at night,
how wonderful!
The car light, it illuminates, and so it's really for safety. You know, and I have a dog that's an outside dog, and I really bought this for him. So hopefully, but I really think this is a great idea.
Yes. And one of our favorite things here is a donation to Creatures Great and Small.
Thank you.
And here's a donation from Greg and I to Project Hope.
Well, thank you so much.
You are very welcome, and we hope you get many more.
And we also have a donation for Rhoda Bolton at Four
Rivers.
Right.
Thank you.
We appreciate that.
We wish you all a very Merry Christmas, and we want to thank you so much for coming and sharing with us today. We could go on.
Oh, these ideas are just great. Thank you both for sharing your ideas.
Yes, we really appreciate it. Yeah. So, I guess, Darleen, we've got to, we always have to wind up things.
I know.
We just get started having fun, we have to go. So.
That's right, but we'll be back.
Yes. Anyway, so I'm Greg.
I'm Darleen.
And we would like to tell our viewers, don't forget what we say every time, give your pet a little extra love today and every day. See you next time.
Bye.
Happy holidays.